how to access our panchayat financial status. I feel this is one and very important thing for every citizen of this country. This content created as part of sustainable development projects named Theni 360, Tamil Nadu 360, Indian Union 360. I will explain a bit about the projects end of the session. Today we are going to understand from the basic. First, you connect to your internet, either to your mobile or to your laptop or desktop or tablet. Then you can open any of these browser to access the website from which we are going to see our panchayat financial report. This is the website address https://accountingonline.gov.in. First of all, let me thank on behalf of every citizen of this country to Government of India for providing or creating such a platform through which every citizen of this country can access their panchayat financial status at any given time. So I thank and respectfully salute them for creating such a open and transparent accounting system, which will help both government as well as the public, and as a nation it will help to build our nation. Now scroll down to the same page, you will come across one particular section called dashboard. In the right side of that section you will have the report MAS registers. In that there are 8 formats. If you click them, you will be get this kind of list with 8 different reports. Out of these 8 reports, we are very interested in the first report, which is very simple and easy to understand. Also, we can understand what is our panchayat income and the expenses for a particular month or a particular year. So once you select this particular report, one, annual receipts and payment accounts, format 1, then you will get into the new window where we need to give some basic informations like this, like whether you want the report for financial year or month wise. In this case or this example, I have given financial year, and financial year as 2018-19, and state I selected for Tamil Nadu, and I have to choose what type of panchayat mine. So you have 3 options to choose. In this case I choose my district level. Then we have to select out of these 3 type of reports, we can choose any one of them. I personally feel subhead will help to understand the report in better way for common public, so I choose subhead as my option to download this report. Then I have to give the input like this CAPTCHA information to the column. Then you click get report. Now the report is in our hand. So it's only take 2 to 3 minutes to download your report maximum if you have slow internet. But we are in digital India, so I am sure we will get it quickly. Now in this new window, you will have the report in PDF format. You can download and save it. You can keep it for your reference at any time. Now you can read and understand income and expenses details of your own panchayat. This is very, very simple. Anyone can do it. The only challenge for now is we don't have the information in our local language. So already government is doing more initiative to do some conversion on that. Hope very soon we will get such information. Now let us move to some sample report to understand what are the information inside. Like this case, I took the sample report of my own Theni block where I live. So here you can see the beginning of the year in 2018-19, the opening balance in the bank, they kept 1.6 crore. Treasury, they have 9 rupees. In post office, they have 3.1 crore as a fund in the opening balance. There is another 5 rupees mentioned. I don't know and what head it is, so I left it as it is. Now we move to the important section, which is like, what is the income and expenses in our TAM? Actually, they mention it as receipts and payments. Now left side, you can see what are the things they generated as a revenue, and then means as income, and what is the expenses in the right hand side. So first we will look into the income, and then we move into the expenses side. First you can see like there are interest receipts which come to them in different heads, like total sanitation campaign, they got it 1120 rupees, and then for MP local area development scheme through which 1.5 lakhs, then come to the rural infrastructure scheme, they get 1155 rupees. Then state finance commission grants, they got 347, and then pooled assigned revenue, it's 1027. Anganwadi minor and major repairs for that purpose, it is like 1115 rupees. Other miscellaneous receipts, in this head we can see something like for National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, they got somewhere around 3,45,000, which is a very good amount. And then under Panchayat Raj program, they mention as a own resource, they mention as almost 59,56,000. This is a very huge income for that. Then some grants from different central and state government. For central government, National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, they got somewhere around 8,74,292. And for from state government, for total sanitation and campaign, they got somewhere around 4,16,000. If we see again from the MLA development scheme, they have somewhere around 2.21 lakhs. From pooled assigned revenue, they got 2.29 lakhs again. Then Anganwadi minor and major repairs, again they got 1.62 lakhs. So totally we can see it's like 82,26,675. This is the total income. And if you are moving to expenses, it's like majorly water supply and sanitation. First one, the total sanitation campaign, they spend almost 12.16 lakhs. And for Panchayat Samiti programs, through own resources, they spend 37.18 lakhs. It's a very huge amount. Again, the National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, via that, they spend almost 8,52,000. And through MLA constituency development scheme, they spend 87,000. For pooled assigned revenue, they spend 41,723. Now if you move to Anganwadi minor and major repairs, they spend almost 7,000 rupees. You might noticed in the income section, they got almost 1.6 lakhs. They spent 7,000 rupees. Okay, now move to National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. Again, through Gram Panchayat program, they spend somewhere around 3,47,000. For total sanitation campaign, again, water supply and sanitation get. Below that, they spend it for TSC, like somewhere around 29,66,132. Now we move to capital outlay and Panchayat Raj program. You can see in this case also the MP and MLA funds were spent somewhere around 6,79,000, and from MLA development schemes they spent 4,23,000. So total expenses we can notice it's coming around 1,03,42,187. From income and expenses we can understand for Theni they spend more than the income, which is like almost 20 plus lakhs higher. So this will give rough idea about what is the income and expenses. I know you will have so many questions regarding this, but in this video we are going to share how to see this report and all. In future, we will understand what are the questions are coming, how to get clarified those things, how you can get involved, all those stuffs we will do in the consecutive videos. Then now I am moving to the next section. It's a closing balance. The end of the year, they closed their account with this information. Like in bank, as a closing balance, they have 1.2 crore. In their treasury, they have 3.3 crores. So finally, we have 4.5 crore in Theni, 2018 and 19 financial year. Now we understood how to see the reports. Now we will see how this, the projects, a little bit introduction to this project. Actually, on January 26th, after attending my first Gram Panchayat meeting, I come across this idea of creating awareness about understanding this report to the people living in my area. Then I thought about expand to Theni district. Then I thought the idea, okay, why I have to stop it to Theni? It is for whole Tamil Nadu we can expand. Then I thought, okay, why only to Tamil Nadu? We are living in India, so let us do it for Indian Union 360. So this is how the projects evolved from my own small village to Theni district, and from Theni district to Tamil Nadu and to Indian Union 360. So just to understand, I wrote a small story about this. I shared the link about that story also, but it is in Tamil. Maybe other language people find difficult to understand. But simple idea is this. How this idea came into my mind is, once I attended my own Gram Panchayat meeting, for that I prepare myself to understanding this report, and then I went to that meeting. Then what happened? It is in that story. From there, this project evolved. That's a basic idea about this project. Now, we move to the goals of each project. Theni 360 project have the aim of train 4 lakhs people of Theni district by 2030, who is able to access their panchayat income and expenses details, understand and able to share that knowledge to fellow citizens. This is the basic aim of Theni 360 project. Then we have Tamil Nadu 360, in that every panchayat of Tamil Nadu state should have at least 5 trained individuals by 2035. It is huge time, I said, because while I start, I'm starting alone. So this duration also we have 130 crore of people in India in different location. I don't know whether I can make it in all languages, but I have the confidence. So I set good and sufficient time. By any means, if we can achieve in very early, it will be good for us as a nation. So the same goal also set for Indian Union 360 project. Every panchayat of Indian Union should have at least 5 trained individuals by 2035, who is able to access their panchayat income and expenses details, understand and share that knowledge to fellow citizen. We will discuss more about these projects and how this is going to influence everyone's life in coming days. But now itself, you might understood why this is very important to all of us. Now, if you like to be part of it, the first step towards it, you can take part and complete this registration form for completing this small little course. I name it like that because I have no other way to name it. So if you taken this course as an individual, you can use the form which is the link given, 360 completion form in that you can fill. And for the non-individuals like the trainers or the group of people who attended this training using this material or videos or relevant informations which I am sharing in the websites, or the organizations, schools, institutions or colleges who use all this information can fill their details in the non-individuals form. Why you have to fill, there is a question always. The only reason I am keeping these forms is we are getting more super and great project across the India, many time, many, many, from many people. But finally, after starting some period, that projects are nowhere. So I don't want to leave this project in that way. To motivate myself as well as give the direction to the project to go towards the goal, this monitoring of course completion is very important, and it is a motivation factor for me also. It is helping me to plan in better way to reach more people to achieve this goal. So it's very important. If you think it is very important, complete this form. And there are informations like your email ID and the contact number. It is not mandated to share that information, but if you wish to get more information in future, you want to take part, you can share. Otherwise, it is not mandatory information to share. Then if you want to take part, it is very simple. You can be a trainer. You can use this link to download the PDF presentation as well as the videos, which you can use it for your own training sessions. After completing the session, you can use the same form to fill out how many people attended the training, all those information through the course completion form, TGO. Apart from this, if you like to attend different kind of courses, it is almost Asan today, means March 2019, I listed somewhere around 70 courses. It will be increasing in time to time in order to achieve the sustainable development in our area. These programs are listed. So you can take part in that also. For that reason, you can use this KS session registration form. These are the some important and immediate action we have to take in the list. One, create the resources like how to manual in all key Indian language. This manual is how to access this. This manual can be used by anyone. If you are a person or you know a person who can help us to convert this in their own language, you are most welcome to let me know, or you can do by yourself and do it your own. And you can use any of this content for your own purpose. It's completely open source. And how to video also all the Indian languages, it's very important. Now I made it both Tamil and English. If you can help me to do it, or you can do directly through in different languages, it will be very much useful. All the Indian languages is very important, because this information should reach every individual of this country. Website for Theni 360, Tamil Nadu 360 and Indian Union 360 under progress. If you want to take part and contribute to this particular project, you can please do it. And mobile application for registration, manual and video delivery, completion registration, all those purpose, we want a mobile app, which will very much helpful to monitor this project and improve ourselves to reach more people in better way, and keep update ourselves to reach more people. And I will be sharing more details through these three websites, and you can get this information at any time you want, and you can keep in touch with me. My name is R. Mahendran, and I use Karuli Rasamahendran as my pen name for my writing and all creative works. And timely, I am using all my time for writing and music creation, and for like independent sustainable development analyst work, and give the training to the people. Thank you very much for giving your valuable time to understand this particular session. We will meet again with very useful informations and in the consecutive videos. Thank you once again. And thank you once again for the Indian Union government for creating such a wonderful platform which help every individual of this country to access their information.